with the spirit of God, moved with the spirit of God. Hallelujah. One is from God. God has been saying a lot to us. You know, God has been saying a lot to us. And I pray that the word of God will come fresh in our lives. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today we are going to be looking at this in part 5. And it has been a series, a long one. You know, last week we saw in the book of Daniel, 11:32. That those that we move in the spirit of God, okay, must hunger for his knowledge. They must hunger for the knowledge of God. They must hunger for the ways of God. They must hunger for the righteousness of God. They must hunger for the power of God. Okay? They must hunger for the power of God. If they must be vessels through which God will display his power and glory. Hallelujah. We pray. We also saw, also from that scripture in Daniel, you know, that those that really move the spirit of God, they should be people that love the truth. They love the truth. Because according to that Daniel, he said those that hate the truth will be flattered. And we deal by the era of flattery. Like we are in the age of flattery. People like to be flattered. Oh, you are fine. Oh, look at this. I like this your dress. The dress that is torn to the waist. You like it. Oh my God. Somebody is naked. Yeah, they are looking very pretty too. You know, somebody are not eating. You know, you know you are not eating. And somebody sees you. You know yourself. You know what I'm going through. And somebody sees you. Say, oh, you are looking glorious. In your heart, you tell the person, say, so, you are being honest with yourself. You tell the person. So you mean, say, nah, are you cursing me or you are praising me? You know, for those who love the truth. You understand my point? Somebody, you know the situation, you know what I'm going through. And then the person is speaking by faith. But I want to say that a lot of people are not even speaking by faith. Because carnality is the border of the day to day. Worldliness is the border of the day to day. You understand my point? Somebody living an immoral life and telling you how many are caught down by the time. If you see the cheek today, or you see that new bubble. You understand my point? And then instead of the man to say, shut up, I'm not going to serve the Lord in righteousness. If that will not say that, I'm going to say, ah, you do, come on, give me five. And that is what people like. That's what is going on today. And God says that because they will cast not the love of the truth in their heart, he will still send them delusion so that they believe more lies. Any person who doesn't want the truth, God will make you to believe more lies. God will send liars to you, people that will lie more lies to you. But I pray that God will have mercy upon us.
Amen.
And not send us anything like, or send us people that will speak the truth to us.
Amen.
People that will tell us when we do right thing, they will praise us. When we are doing wrong, they will also to praise us. And they God give us that spirit of meekness to appreciate people that correct us. Because sometimes to correct people is not very easy. When you are correcting somebody, the person takes offense. So may God give us that spirit of humility. So that when they are correcting us, we'll accept it and not become angry in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
So we are going to continue today. The Bible says in Amos 3:3, he said, can two walk together? Except they be agreed. Can two people walk together if they're not in agreement? You can't walk with somebody that when you are going this way, the person is going to that way. You can't walk with somebody, your fellowship with somebody cannot be sweet on every of you like the same thing. You understand my point? You can't, just like I said, best of the same feather will flock together. If you are not the same feather with the Holy Ghost, you cannot move with the Holy Ghost. You got to have the same feather with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Okay. I say you have to have the same feather with who? With the Holy Ghost. So that you can fly together with the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost will not be flying this way, then you are flying that way. Or he's flying high, or you are done. No. You have to have the same feather. So the Bible says, can two walk together except they agree? In Matthew 4:1-2, I like this. Look at this. He said, then, what Jesus led up, okay? He was led up of the Spirit. Who led him? The Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. Who led him into the wilderness?
The Spirit.
Now, look at it. If his flesh was guiding him,
If he was being led by his flesh, he will not follow the Holy Spirit to go to the place where he will tempt him. But he followed the Holy Spirit to be tempted. Holy Spirit said, come, now I'm going to show, I'm going to prove to them. And he followed. But thank God that by the grace of God, he did not fail the temptation. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because like I said to you, if God will bring you to the place of temptation, God will give you grace to overcome the temptation.
Amen.
He brought Israel to the place because God needed them when they came out from Egypt. He brought them to the Red Sea. Did God abandon them there?
No.
No. God parted the Red Sea and they moved through the Red Sea. But when Pharaoh tried to do the same, because God was not with Pharaoh, Pharaoh got into the water because he was divided. And God said, because I'm not with you, God removed his hand from the water. And the water came together and destroyed Pharaoh. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So when you are walking with the Holy Ghost, don't mind anywhere if he leads you, follow him. If you meet an obstacle, he will take care of it. Anywhere he says go, you must go. Hallelujah. Amen. And people who walk with the Holy Ghost, they are not mindful of what happens to them. Because they know God is bigger than whatever I will be on the way.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the Bible says, and when he has fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hunger. But we thank God. You know the rest of the story. The Lord, listen to me. The Lord is not going to force you. The Lord is not going to force you or force himself upon you. God is not going to force his ways upon you. God is not. So if somebody is going to expect that God will force you, say you must do it. No. You must do it. No. If God is going to force himself on people, the whole world will have been saved by force. The whole world would have been saved. Everybody would have been born again. Because nobody can resist God. It's not as though God has won the power. But it's not in the character of God to force people against their will. God made us free moral agents. Free moral agents, in other words, God created you and gave you the power of choice. Of choice. The power to choose what you want and what you don't want. So that you cannot say, oh, God, you forced me to come. God did not force you to come. You came to church this morning because you chose to come. And I pray, let it be that you follow the Holy Spirit to come. So that the blessings that God has prepared for you today, you will receive them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So God is not going to force you. But you yourself, it is you that will have to do what? Yield them. Willingly. Yield yourself. Yield yourself, because that's where the blessing is. That's where the blessing is. When you personally, willingly yield yourself to God, to be part of what He's doing right now and about to do on earth by His Spirit. God is on the move. I say the Lord is on the move. Forget whatever is going on. Forget whatever is happening. God is moving. The Spirit of God is moving. I say the Spirit of God is moving. Just join to be part of what God is doing so that the blessing that God has prepared for people that will walk with Him, you will be part of those that will receive the blessing.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Therefore, you must align yourself. Align, in other words,
position.
Yeah?
Position.
You must comply, conform. Okay, I think align it for conform. You must conform to the way of God. Align yourself. You know what? Put yourself in the same line with God. Yes, I think the same line with God. Put yourself in the same line. Don't go outside of the line. Do you understand my point? Put yourself on the same line with God so that you can move with Him. When you go to parade ground, when you go to parade ground and people there, they form their lines. Their lines. And inspector goes, if inspector, for example, if I'm here, I should not be able to see the length of the person behind the first person. If they are truly in alignment, I should not see the length of the person at the front. Why? Because Every person is just on a straight line. If I'm here, unless I go to the side, and if person is not on alignment, is not alignment, then you see the person's leg out a bit. That person that's not on alignment, the person's leg will be out. But if the person on alignment, the person's leg will be behind everywhere. Just moment, you just see a straight line. So you must be on the straight line with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You must align your thoughts, your ways to the higher thoughts, because the ways of God are higher. The thoughts of God are higher. So you must bring yourself and align your thoughts, align your way to the higher ways and the thoughts of God, so that you'll be able to flow with the Spirit of the Lord, to flow with Him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must be sensitive to the living of the Spirit. You must be sensitive. You must be sent to. That is why you pray this morning and say, tell God to deliver you from every satanic manipulation and influence, and even of your flesh. Sensitivity means that you are ready to catch even the smallest speaking of the Holy Ghost. You are sensitive. Do you understand my point? You are very sensitive that even the Holy Ghost says more things like this one, like whispers to you, you will pick it up. But when you are not, you don't know, like somebody say, why you tell somebody say, why you so sensitive? Somebody not talking, that's not what you touching, how you scream like this one. But who are not sensitive, even if you pinch them, they like nothing happened to them. Or if you hit the person, bam, waiting. But somebody who is sensitive, very sensitive, even when the person is sleeping, you just walk into the room, the person wakes up. Why? Because the person is very, very what? Sensitive. So you must be sensitive to the voice of the Lord for you to be to move the Holy Ghost. If you are not sensitive, the Holy Ghost will tell you to move this way. You are dead. You say, well, I didn't hear anything now. He has spoken to you. Because God, you remember Elijah. Remember the story of Elijah. Elijah said, there was whirlwind, there was earthquake, there was storm and all those things, but he didn't see God, but he heard what?
A small voice.
A still small voice. God may whisper to your spirit. If you are not sensitive, you will not get it. So you are not going to expect that God will shout your name. Hey, Agnes, 10 times. Forget that. God may not shout your name. Hey, John Boo. Okay, leave all that. It may be a very tiny voice. It may be a small prompting in your heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you must be sensitive enough to pick it up. In other words, your spiritual antenna will be very sharp. Your spiritual what? Antenna for the devil what?
Yeah.
Very sharp. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, having said this, now look at Psalm 110. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Psalm 110. He said, the Lord said unto my Lord. The Lord said unto my Lord. David was the one speaking, but this was not, it was not about David. David was speaking prophetically. David was speaking prophetically, but was speaking about the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, he said, the Lord said, who is the Lord? The Most High God. Said unto my Lord Jesus, hallelujah, said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand. Where is Jesus Christ sitting right now?
At the right hand of God.
He says, sit down at my right hand until I make thy enemies thy footstool. Sit down. Jesus Christ has come to the world. He has died and rose from the dead as he has seated at the right hand of God. But the devils are still in operation. Amen. Satan is still operating. My great devils, witchcraft, principalities, power, they are still operating. And these are the enemies of the Lord Jesus Christ. They are the enemies of the Lord Jesus. But the Lord said to Jesus, say, sit down, you have done your own. Sit down until I make these enemies of yours your footstool. You understand? Your footstool. You will march on them. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Now, but look at what he said. The Lord shall send a rod The Lord shall send the rod of thy strength, the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Out of Zion. Praise the Lord. The Lord will send the what? The rod of thy strength out of what?
Zion.
Out of Zion. Now, rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. The Lord Jesus Christ and is sitting in heaven. God said he will now, he should rule in the midst of his enemies. I'm going to see something here. Rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. They are asking to sit down. Sit down at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool. Are you hearing me? Now, but at the same time, he said the Lord will set the rock of his own strength, the rock of Jesus' strength, out of Zion. Now, then he said, rule, the person that is sitting up there, God is saying to him, rule in the midst of your enemies. Where is he going to rule? Thank you, Jesus. Thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power.
Yes.
Thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. In the beauty of holiness from the womb of the morning, thou hast in view of thy youth. Now, let me give our lives. Child of God, the church, listen, the church, you, the integral member of the church, you are a rod of the strength of Jesus Christ on the earth.
Yes, yes.
Are you following?
Yes, yes.
Now, because you are the rod, you are, God is going to send you out from Zion because you are here upon Mount Zion.
Mm-hmm.
So God is sending you the rod of his strength out of Mount Zion, and through you, he is going to establish, he's going to exercise that authority of his over his enemies. So that is for a child of God. Anywhere the church has lost its light, anywhere the church has lost its saltiness, you see that the kingdom of God will be as though it's not the existence in that area. It is a church, therefore, that God will use to establish his kingdom, establish his reign. When we stand here and say we command and decree that light will shine, when we stand in this day that we bind every demonic activity, God will back it up from heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus will back it up from heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Because he has given us the word, the power, the authority to do what? To rule on his behalf.
Yes.
So if we cannot exercise that is authority and power on his behalf, it is like Jesus is not ruling in that place. Oh, I hope somebody got it. So you, but look at it. Thy people, who are his people? You are his person. You, we are the people of God. Thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. So the question is, are you willing? Are you willing to do, to exercise, to decree, to establish the kingdom of God? Are you willing? That's the question. Are you willing? Do you get angry? Oh, I remember the story of one young man many years ago. This young man was in the bus. He was in the bus. You know, like a conductor and a passenger. You understand my point? This young man was inside the bus and he came down and maybe someone who really, I don't know, I forgot where they have the story. I don't know, many years ago. And then an old man came down from the bus and was asking, telling conductor, first of all, they were arguing inside the bus, telling conductor, give my money. And then I don't know what happened. Then he began to tell the conductor, you will see today. When I come down from this bus, you will see today. You know the way some people go. The man had chance. So as he was coming down, after he has fallen and I'm living, they have settled him. He was coming down to exercise the demonic power. He told the boy to come down, he told the conductor, he had come down. Even though the boss was about to move, he had come down. With the demonic influence, authority, The boy came down. The conductor came down. And he began to display. He told the conductor. People were there. People thought this was a joke. He told the conductor, okay, begin to get tickets. Remove your clothes. Conductor of movie is called. A young man, a young Christian in the bus, got angry and came down. He said, for what? Boy, wear your shirt. Wear your trousers. All the things the boy was putting down, the boy began to put them back. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, Satan cannot have authority in this place. The Lord God Almighty is here. I command in the name of Jesus Christ, wear your clothes. That is the boy manifesting, displaying the power of God in the day of God's power.
Yes.
That was the boy that was willing in the day of God's power. The question is, are you willing? Do you get angry when you see demonic activities around you? Do you get angry? Or you praise them? See, that little man there, see this guy, wow, so you get power. Is that what you say? Or you get angry and say, the name of Jesus, I paralyze you. I command your power to be destroyed. I command you that the boast of the money power, because the Bible says, confounded be all they that serve graven images, that boast themselves of idols. He said, worship before you gods. Worship before you God. What is your testimony? What do you do? What is your heart in that? What do you do? How do you behave? What's your action in the midst of such situation? He said that people shall be willing in the day of God's power. Are you willing? You are the rod of his strength.
Yes.
You are the rod of God's strength that God is sending out of the church. Yes. To go and establish his rule. To go establish the authority of Jesus on the earth.
Yes.
For God to be glorified on the earth. Are you willing? No, are you willing?
Yes.
He said that people shall be willing in the day of his power, in the beauty of holiness, because he has made us holy and righteous. He has made you holy and righteous, not by your power. Because the Bible says he created us in righteousness and true holiness. Now, he said, God, from the womb of the morning, thou hast a view for the freshness of your youth. The freshness of your youth. Remember the scripture says in the book of 1 John. He said, little children, he said, you say that overcome them. Overcome them because what? You are strong. You are strong. The freshness of your youth. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
The freshness of your youth. When we talk about freshness of your youth, we're not talking about being a young man or a teenager. No, we're talking about freshness of your coming to the kingdom of God, knowing the Lord, being zealous for the things of God. Honestly speaking, I remember when I got saved, the kind of zeal I had and of the truth, there were things that God did through me in the days, in my early days of Christianity. My friend here will tell you, I want to tell them, if you don't mind. He told me, I came to his office one day, those days, okay? Before I come on again, I did that. But he said, he saw the power of God. Those are some of the things that convince him. He saw the power of God. I went to my father's house. I bought down the idols. I bought down all the nonsense. And my most senior brother told me, I said, I've gone to Papa's house. I went to the village. He said, I said, Papa is born again. He said, what is born again? I said, Papa has given his life to Christ. And I bought the village. He said, you don't want that thing up there? What can I buy the home there? I said, yes, I want. You still don't be anger. He said, you ready for better? I said, Papa is not dying. Papa is not dying. I bought it. Papa will not die. My father didn't die. Child of God, some of you are not willing to go to the village. You see the money that people around you. You take quiet as though it's normal. Whereas you have God that carry God in you.
Come on.
You have God in you. You have a greater one before the Bible says, greater is he that is in you,
yes,
than the devil that are in the world.
Yes, yes.
You are dead cattailing demons. You are dead cattailing evil forces. And no wonder darkness is all around. Why? Because the church has been to show forth her light. We are the light of the world.
Yes.
Are we willing? You must be willing today.
Yes.
You are willing because these are the days of God's power. These are the days of Elijah. And like the days of Elijah. These are the days to prove that our God rules and reigns. These are the days to prove that power belongs to God and not to Satan. And if you don't do it, Satan will oppress you. You can't sit on the fence. You can't sit on the fence. You sit on the fence on your own. And you sit on the fence on your own. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So the church is the rod of God's strength that is expected to go out. Yes. And to enforce the victory of Jesus in the world over the powers of darkness. For child of God, the church must be willing. You must be willing as a child of God. I say you must be willing. It is through the church that the Lord will rule in the midst of his enemies. It is through the church that Jesus will rule in the midst of his enemies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How will people know? Don't consider it. How do people know that God has power? We came into this community, the battles we fought in this company alone. Your position, but God gave us victory. We came in here one Sunday morning. We had got this roof, but if the altar was there, and we are worshiping under the help of open heaven. And then we came here, one woman, and was telling to get out of this place. What a occulting woman, witch, you know? She had a cross there. I said, no, I bought the land. Then we don't want you there again. The wife was troubled. She didn't want to go. She was using her witchcraft to want to stay there. Sunday morning, she came there dressed up in all those that spiritual garments, regalia, went back front with everything. And she went to that corner where the generator is. And I was standing here on this side. The brethren were passing the gate. And she walked in and she went to that place. And she began to make an incantation. You have to do this one. You have to do this one. I kept quiet. Somewhere along the line, I got angry in the spirit. And I said, everything you are saying, I direct them back to you. I said, run out of this company, I said, bad woman. I said, run, we have to run, I said, back to the home of God over here. Child of God, if I was not willing to demonstrate the power of God, so I'd be here to come in the church. God gave us a victory over her. I said, pass out of this place at the end of the day. That is displaying the power of God. Are willing to do it in the day of his power.
Yes.
If you don't do it, Satan will use our hands to walk on the ground. If you are not willing to stand up in the name of Jesus, if you are not willing to take your place as the rod of God's strength, child of God, Satan will mess you up. So you must stand up. God has given you authority.
Yes.
He has given you the power.
Amen.
There will be challenges on the way. I say there will be challenges on the way. The children of Israel in the day of battle. Oh, Kasei Sayabata.
Thank you, Jesus.
The armies of Israel. Yay, Kasei Yabata. Then these brethren, they went to fight against Goliath. When Goliath made noise, whoa, we're going to fight. I will kill all of you. Fear will take upon our coach. They were shaking. And the little young man, yes. The little young man, yes. And the scripture will say, yes, I had the dew of his youth. That had the view of his youth.
Yes.
A little young man, David, that took food to his brethren in the battlefield. When he got there and heard the voice of Goliath making noise, he said, who is this man? Who is the circumcised this? The senior one said, you have come again, Lord. We know you. I'm the boy. We know you. Talk at it. You have come here. Look. This not for small children. He said, no. I will destroy this man. He said, introduce him to King Saul. Oh, Kaye, da. They introduced him to King Saul. He said, listen, I'm going to destroy that giant. He said, how are you going to do it? He said, the God that gave me victory over the lion. The God that gave me victory over the bear. We gave me victory over this obstacle side to this. The king said, look, this young man, I know. You cannot find a giant because I'm not trained. He brought back his own armor, his own weapons of war. Then he looked at them and said, I can't use these ones. I can't use these ones. I believe my God. He took back to the brook. 2 5 4 foot means grace. He went in the grace of God because 5 means grace. He went 2 5 stones, body stone, took a catapult. You will not fight a giant with a catapult. They took a catapult and went to the battlefront and put a stone, one of the stones, in the catapult. And Goliath was making noise. And we do this. Then he told him, listen to me. You cannot defy the armies of God I will cut off your head. And so David failed the head. Listen to me. It was not the hand of David, because hand of God. The hand of David came the hand of God.
Yes.
And the rod of Moses, it was called the rod of God, for the rod of your mighty God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. And the end, Holy Ghost made me. Because when you made Holy Ghost to take over,
yes.
When you made Holy Ghost to take over,
yes.
When you shot Holy Ghost directed the stone, and did Goliath at the very place where the shield, where the helmet could not protect him, and Goliath fell. How can you speak? How can you say an ordinary stone will kill a giant? How can you say? How did the stone get to the place? Located the place because a man that is prepared for war, directed for war, everywhere is covered. David, the stone did not miss. The stone did not hit the helmet. The stone did not hit the breastplate. The stone did not hit all the gadgets on the hand, on the shoulder. The stone went straight and caught him at the forehead. And he died. Child of God, David was
willing.
In the day of God's power.
Yes.
If somebody's willing to demonstrate the power
yes,
of God,
yes, yes. I am willing.
Shout, I am willing.
I am willing.
You have to be willing. You have to be willing. God is ready. God is at work now. There's a rise up in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, God will back you up.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't have to run. Because greater is he that is with you already.
Yes.
Than the devil that is in the world. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank. Oh, my God. Hey, Jesus, we thank you.
Amen.
We thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you.
Thank
you. So the church should indeed, you should indeed be willing to take your place and exercise the authority and the power of Christ in the day of his power. These are the days for the power of God. We are in the days of demonstration of the power of God. If you are not doing it, listen to me. You are not human. There are people out there that are doing it.
Mm-hmm.
We are not only saying you really have a part of them.
Mm-hmm.
There are people demonstrating the power of God.
Yes.
There are people that are experiencing miracles.
Yes.
There are people who are experiencing miracles daily. Child of God, who will appear? Listen to me. When you run from doing the work of God, you will not be able to run from the devil when he comes to attack your own life.
Word.
When you run from doing the work of God, when the devil comes against you as a new leader, you will not be able to withstand. Do you understand my point?
Yes.
And those, do you understand my point?
Yes.
So you will be willing. Join this chariot of God's kingdom. Move the Holy Ghost. When the enemy comes against you in your own life, the experience you have in the field, you use the experience to destroy that devil. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That will come against you. You don't need to call someone, you will bind. You exercise the authority that God can say to you, say, whatever you bind on the earth, I'll be bound in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you lose on the earth, I'll be lose in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to lose yourself from every chain and shackle of Satan. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, so the church will be willing to take up this and sign of authority and power of Christ in the day of God's power. That is the day that God is willing to release his power to make his name known. God wants to make his name known. There are people who will not believe until they see what God has done through you. Do you understand my point?
Mm-hmm.
There are people who are looking at you. You tell them to come to church, you tell them to get money, they say, what is your own? A young man, I'm going to stop here, oh God, having God to say, oh Father, have mercy. Many years ago, I went to preach to somebody, I told this story before. I went to preach to somebody, you know, I was working then. I went to this man's office, he was very rich. I mean, very rich. I went to his office, I went to him. When I finished talking about what I was going to install in his office, you know, not to like mess money up. You know, I'm going to carry this amplifier and maybe this speaker and then maybe this stand, these three things. This picture are too big, they are too big. You know computer. Desktop. The desktop, you have the watch, you have the monitor. You have the CPU, you have the keyboard. You understand my point? Those are the things I was going to carry to go to Nitel office to find out whether they're compatible with the Nitel line. We compare our equipment is compatible with Nitel line. From Ogunland of Drive to Ori. Into Shino Lagos, you know that area. It's not far. The man told me that I come with a car, I said I didn't come with a car. You know, it's okay, no problem. You know, okay, you carry the CPU in one message. You carry the monitor in that time, one brand new 504, I can call it STI or ST or whatever. You carry brand new, you carry it in that one. Then you will carry the keyboard in another brand new car. That is 3 cars already. He said that you enter the third one, I mean the fourth one, to go like. And then you are carrying the keyboard, one car. You mess up money. The man told me, I said, sir, you don't need that. I'm inviting you. He said, Pastor, say, listen, let me tell you, I don't go to church. I have money. I don't get sick. Now, come to the good church. I'm using his word. Now, come to the good church. But I pray for him. And they said, you need Christ. You need to be born again. Money will not save you. When he was arrested, he was in prison. One day I saw, I was coming back from work and I saw evening times. I don't know why they still said evening times in Lagos. That evening paper. And I saw the newspaper. I saw the man, his picture. He was carrying Bible. He wrote, he's not born again in prison. I said, yes. Child of God. There are people that will not get born again until they see the power of God, until they see problem in their life. You are to go out there and demonstrate the power of God. Yes. Let people see Christ in you.
Yes.
Let them know that your God is a living God. The world presently needs solution. The world presently needs answer to COVID-19. Amen, somebody.
Yes. Yes.
Nobody will die in nature. Go tell them that in our church will not die. That God is giving us a life here. It's not our power, it's not our mind. There are people who don't want to die. Let them come and their life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Child of God, check your brother and receive your miracle.
Yes.
There are people who can't give their life to God because they don't see what God is doing in your life. Child of God, stand up in your faith and receive that miracle. Believe God, bind the demon that is troubling your life. Some people here, your problems are from the village. Your problems are from satanic altar, dedication that will talk over your life. You are there, playing with demons. You are there, playing with the enemy. Rise up and call down fire. Let fire of God come. Oh, my kishan. Call down fire in your anger. Be angry, child of God. Stop rubbing nonsense cream. I said stop rubbing nonsense powder. You keep rubbing nonsense powder. That is why nonsense will be looking at you as beautiful. You are looking at nonsense as beautiful because you have put powder in the face of nonsense. Rise up. Be angry in your spirit. Enough of this nonsense. Satan, I bind you.
Yes.
You have no power over my life.
Yes.
Greater is he that is with me than you that is in the world.
Yes.
Then Lord Jesus Christ defeated you more than 2,000 years ago. He defeated your master. All of you, witches and wizards, who are you? The one that is with me is better than your master that you are serving.
Yes.
The sword of the Lord cut off your head.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Child of God, rise up and be angry with the devil. Yes. Be willing and stand up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God will back you up.
Amen.
Heaven will back you up.
Amen.
I say heaven will back you up.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Bow your head. Don't bow your head.